reassembly of the phono plug and hold switch is rather straightforward. The components are small, so they're a bit tricky to work with, but you just place them in the proper positions. You'll see the phono plug cut out in the rear cover, and you'll see the rear hold switch cut out. Now you place those in their respective positions, lining them up as best you can. It may take a few seconds just to get everything to snap in place. Just take your time, ensure nothing is bending or being forced into place. And once that's done, just ensure the cables lay semi-flat and insert the Phillips head screws. Now again, these are very small Phillips screws and they take very little torque to stay in place. So use caution, you don't want to strip any threads during this reassembly. Once the screws are in, just lay the cable flat and use a piece of tape to secure the ribbon cables to the rear cover. I used the piece of tape that came with the original iPod. You could use black electrical tape or masking tape or whatever you have non-conductive like that.